currently walking to the car, and the weather is actually a lot better outside than it was from the window.
Quite pleasant at the moment.
Yeah. So I'm not sure I told you guys where we're going today, but we're going to Disney World. We're going to spend pretty much the whole day there. There's a couple of places I really want to see, like, I want to see, I think it's like the Beauty and the Beast dining hall, and then the Cinderella's Palace, all those places, all those movies I watched when I was little, except Tobias hasn't watched any of them, so he doesn't really know how epic they will be, which is a bit sad. But anyways, because we only have one day in Disney World, I didn't really want to budget too much time, because theme parks are cool and stuff, but I think they're really more fun if you had kids with you or if you had friends with you. But as it is just the two of us, I feel like one day will be enough. So I definitely want to see Magic Kingdom, especially at night to see the fireworks. But I reckon we can probably fit in another theme park as well, potentially two, depending how we go and how many rides Toby goes on. So yeah, should be pretty interesting. Magic Kingdom. Just a little before 9 a.m. so it's actually only 8:58, but it is already really crowded, so I guess a lot of people want to go see Disney World. But to be fair, I think it's Easter Saturday, so it's the long weekend in America as well. I somehow forgot that would be the case. Sorry, I got interrupted because I had to pay for parking. But anyways, what I was gonna say is that I completely forgot that Easter holiday that we have in Australia is pretty much the same in America. So whilst planning this trip, I didn't realize that America would be having the long weekend too, which is why it's actually really packed, even though this park is just about to open. And even in the hotel, it was crazy busy. We didn't get the room that I originally paid for, but they actually just upgraded us instead, which was super nice. Beauty and the Beast castle area, which is like pretty cool because Beauty and the Beast was my favorite Disney movie growing up, so I definitely wanted to come here. So pretty excited, and everything is so Beauty and the Beast-esque. It's so cool. I love it. It's just amazing. So happy we managed to get here. I don't think Tobias has really any idea what everything here is.
I think I've seen it when I was
You've seen it?
Really young, but okay. It wasn't
but,
really my favorite.
Yeah, he doesn't appreciate it as much as I do. I'm just so happy and it's just so amazing. On Magic Kingdom. I think it's called Haunted Mansion, which is basically just
like a haunted ghost house.
Yeah, you sit in the car and it just takes you around. So I tried to film some stuff there, but it was pretty dark and my camera's not that great, so hopefully you get to see some footage, but maybe not too heaps.
We hope nobody tries to burn the door.
That was good timing.
Yeah, it was good timing. The only thing that I'm wondering about is where was Aurora the whole time? There was like the whole Sleeping Beauty, like Maleficent was there, Prince Philip was there, the three godmothers were there, but no Aurora. What's up with that? Was she just sick today? Did she call in sick? I'm going to assume it was a sick day. She had a bad day. We're going into another ride now, Pirates of the Caribbean. Am I recording?
Is yes. That?
yeah, so apparently this is a boat ride. I'm motion sickness, so I really hope this isn't going to be too bad, but we will see. So we just got out of the ride. Apparently, Tobias finds it disappointing.
Yeah, it's like shortest Pirates of the Caribbean ride ever. I think it's like a third of the one in Los Angeles.
Okay, well, I've never been to any of them, so I thought that was okay, but it did feel kind of short for a ride in general. But it explains why the wait time was only 15 minutes.
Right, concentrate everybody. Are you ready now? One, two, three!
Dreams come true!
Those voices! It's beautiful!
See, we all believe together.
We've left Magic Kingdom just for a little bit. We're going to see Animal Kingdom instead and see what that's all about.
Tree of Life. See, it kind of looks like we're in the middle of nowhere. But really, just in an amusement park. Kind of cool.
Apparently in this Animal Kingdom, it's kind of like a park. They have, they kind of have animals as well.
Supposedly.
Yeah, I thought it would be a theme park based on the animals in the Disney movies, and it kind of is, but it also has real life animals apparently, so which is good because I love zoos, because I love animals.
We're gonna head down by the watering hole, and if we get lucky, we might find a black rhino. They are an endangered species, only about 5,000 left in the wild, and this is due to poaching. Now, unfortunately, the black rhinos are being hunted for their horns, which are made out of keratin, the same thing that your hair and fingernails are made out of. This means the horns don't have any special properties, but that hasn't stopped people from trying to take them. They are the emblem of Harambe Reserve.
I don't know if you can tell, but I'm super tired. I think the jet lag or whatever has finally caught up. Because I don't even know.
You were like, and now you're like,
Yeah, yesterday traveling like 30 hours all up and kind of sleeping on and off, I think my body just never really regulated to any particular time zone or anything. So I was like super energetic this morning, and then at about 1 or 2, I'm just like crashing really badly, and I'm drinking lots of caffeine.
Even
and
the sugar is not keeping you up today.
Like nothing's working, and I don't drink coffee, and I'm not about to start, so I can't do that. So I'm just super tired, and it's what time is it now? It's like
it
4
is
o'clock.
Four. Just past 4 o'clock.
Yeah, it's just past 4 o'clock. We want to go back to Magic Kingdom at about 8 because we want to see the fireworks. So we have another 4 hours to kill. Just got out of the safari, which was actually really good, but because I was so tired, I kind of slept for some of it, which was really bad.
And it was a really bumpy ride. Yeah, so I'm surprised you managed to fall asleep on it.
So I think what we're going to do is try and fit in another park to see if I can stay awake for that. Actually, talking to you guys is making me more awake now, so maybe I should just do that for the next 4 hours. Just kidding.
3 hours of vlogging.
Yeah. So I'm going to another park now, try and kill some time there, and then we'll head back to Magic Kingdom. Well, we're back at Magic Kingdom. We actually didn't end up going to any other parks because I figured we're starting to get late, and we wanted to get a good, not seat, but photo area for the fireworks. So we thought we may as well just hang out here, and we're gonna go see It's a Small World After All now, because that was the ride that I went on when I was like just 5 or 6 years old. So I thought I would try it out and see what Disney World is.
I did a lot of searching for things online. winds of the Caspian Sea.
See what a little wishing you do?